All right, I was going to start by sharing my PowerPoint. So this is a photo taken by Kevin Carter. He is a reporter, okay? And he is a very famous, maybe you and I, we might not know him very well. Yeah, but he's famous because of this particular photo that he took, okay? And that made him famous. He was in Africa, certain part of Africa. He was, a reporter. So he was in a hurry going up to the plane, flying back to US, you know, and he saw this girl. This is a girl, and she was so skinny, you know. Yeah, I mean, you saw this type of picture before, right? And she is about to die. Yeah, you can see a voucher behind her. Yeah, just any time to eat her up. So he took this photo and he went up to the plane and then fly back to US. And he published this photo, you know, and you know, in 1993, I think he became famous because he received an award, yeah, the Pulitzer Award for the reporters, yeah, and he became famous, yeah, and he was rewarded in a certain way. But, you know, what happened, the sad thing is that people begin to criticize him. You say, Kevin, how can you leave this girl, you know, in this stage, yeah, and then you just come back to America? Yeah, you should extend your help to her in any way, you know. Yeah, but, you know, he felt very guilty and he went back to this place to visit the camp where they are providing food for the children. So, you know, they found out that she actually managed to crawl, yeah, to this food feeding program, the base there. You know, he found out that this girl actually, you know, that they reached there. You know, but she died eventually because of malnutrition. Okay, so he feel helpless. Yeah, you know, I should have helped her, you know, or in any way, you know. And he came back, he still got a lot of criticism from people, you know, the public, you know. And eventually, he killed himself. Yeah, he committed suicide. Yeah. So what I want to share to you this story is that no matter how good you are in your profession, in how well you are trained, you know, how famous you are, you know, and you are successful, you know, you are educated even. I have a friend, a good friend of my family, who she is a PhD, a professor. You know, she went into depression one day, you know. Yeah, and she became like a little girl. You know, he come to my house, visit me, and he mess up my daughter's hair. You know, my daughter asked me, he said, how come Jeje become like this, you know? And during service time, she sit in front of the pastor when we are preaching, you know? And so embarrassing, you know? And then after that, she feel regrets, all these sort of things, you know? So she go through emotional hurts and pain, actually, yeah? So we are vulnerable to this. I myself actually go to they call this burnout. Yeah, burnout. After 15 years in full-time ministry, I feel helpless. Yeah, in certain way, you know, I'm also like a perfectionist. And the Lord deal with me the way how I'm thinking, not in line with the Bible. Yeah, sometimes the way how we think and how we take care of our children is not in line with the Word of God. It's like our culture, okay, expectation and so on, you know. Yeah, and so the Lord, when I am resting, you know, for that 3 months, I thank God. Yeah, he visited me, speak to me, and tell me, he said, Lazarus, you are not the Messiah. I am the Messiah. You are trying to save your church. Yeah, it is me who are more concerned for a church. He said, take care of yourself. Yeah, then you can, yeah, go a longer distance. At that time, I felt, I cannot be a good father. I can't even stand some noise and so on. I have to be on my own, you know, just praying and worshiping God, you know. But God really draw me to a place, full stop. Yeah. And one night, as I walking out, you know, I was in Lahat Datuk, you know, Susan Tang, he has a place called Station of Lime. Maybe some of you know. I was resting there with my whole family. I walk out and look at the stars, the starry night, looking at the star, and the Lord spoke to me. Yeah, he says that, you know, through one sharing in the daily bread, he said, our life is just like an orchestra, a symphony, yeah, and God is the one who wrote this symphony, you know. You see, sometimes the symphony has the high and the low, you know, even a full stop, a pause, you know. Yeah, but without all this, you know, it is not a beautiful symphony. Yeah, a complete one will have the high, the low, and the exciting, and the quiet moments, you know. You see, same thing, Lazarus, your life is like that. Yeah, don't look at it. Nah, when you are not able to do anything, you are like you lost your value as a pastor. Yeah, you see, to me, you are still the same. You're still valuable to me. Yeah, even though you don't do anything. Yeah, so I can't even play guitar. You know, holding a guitar to me is too strenuous. I can only sing to God with my own voice, you know. Yeah, and I thank God I have some good pastor around me encouraging me. He said, Lazarus, just rest. Eat, you know, and play. And don't feel guilty. Yeah, I cannot believe. He said, he's one of the pastor, very wise. He said to me, he said, Pastor Lazarus, ministry is always there. You must take care of yourself. He said, one day you are going to rise up and help many people who go through depression. True enough, I'm doing it now. Amen. Yeah. And so look at your life. Yeah. It's not the end of the world. Yeah. It's the beginning. He's the Alpha and the Omega who is going to write your life. So don't give up your life. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. And so, you know, we're looking at people who are famous, who are rich, right? Anthony Bourdain is one of the, yeah, documentary which I like to watch, but he's no longer around. Yeah. He is a chef. Yeah, and he is very rich. He travel, he do documentary. And so the last place about 2 years ago, he died in Paris Hotel while he's doing a shooting, yeah, for his program in Paris, you know. If we wonder, he has a lovely daughter that he loved. How can he so cruel leaving her behind, right? Yeah, but there must be something emotional he cannot solve. Okay, so no matter how rich, how famous, how good you are in your profession, and you must know how to take care of our soul. Amen. Take care of your soul. And take care of the soul of other people around you. It's so important. That's why Jesus said, if you can earn the whole world and lose your own soul, yeah, does it profit? Yeah. So your soul is so important. Yeah. So, yeah, even with pastor's son, yeah, Rick Warren's son, yeah, he go through depression, yeah. Yeah, many years he's on medication. And one day, just, you know, few years back, he took his life, you know, with a gun, you know. Yeah, and sometimes we say, hey, this thing happened in the church as well. I have a member who committed suicide. I counsel him, you know. I feel so bad, you know. Yeah, and I no longer want to say, you know, if people will kill themselves, they cannot go to heaven. I don't say things like that. Those, they are my stand, you know. But I know now when I talk to people, they are hearing voices, you know, that's beyond their control. And the voice just oppress them, okay? And they just have to do it, you know. Yeah, I have members, I minister to her. She said, I hear the voice tell me, I say, you must do this or else I will kill your family. Yeah, so they are, during that time, yeah, the enemy is overpowering them, okay? So I don't condemn, and I don't put, yeah, that kind of statement, yeah, to people, yeah, who experience this. So Christ transformation prayer. Can I get Anita? Can you read for me?
1 Thessalonians 5:23. Now may the God of peace himself sanctify you completely, and may your whole spirit, soul, and body be preserved blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The goal of this series is to equip the body of Christ to be free to live the life of an overcomer and then to be used to set others free.
Amen. Thank you. Hallelujah. Okay, so here, CTP focus on the presence of Christ. Okay, so this is not a method. Even though it looks like a method, but the Holy Spirit is working very powerfully during the prayer. Okay, yeah. So, and the healing of body, soul, and spirit. Okay, the three parts. Afterwards, I go to this. Right, so I believe that they are made of three parts. There's a, Thessalonian, Paul pray for the believers, that your whole soul, spirit, body preserved blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And so the goal of this series is to equip the body of Christ, the saint, for the work of ministry, to set free their own life and to overcome them and to be used, okay, to set others free. Okay, so as the book of Ephesians mentioned that, you know, yeah, God wants to equip all of us, yeah, for the work of ministry. And we are made out of three parts, soul, body, and spirit. Okay, so in 3 John 1:2, it says, "Beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things and be in health, just as your soul prosper." Yeah, so we are not only emphasizing on spirit well-being, yeah, physically body well-being. Also, we all know how to take care of our body. Okay, so, you know, we comb our hair, you know, when we are cold, we dress properly. When we are not well, we are sick physically, we go and see a doctor or take medication, or we exercise to strengthen our physical body. Okay, so the five senses, we will take care. All right, and the body can get ill, can get sick, and the soul also can get unwell. Amen. Our soul will have cough and sneezing and flu. And so when our soul not well, so what will happen? Okay, first of all, we look at the soul. The soul part can be, as we say, our personality, or the soul in the Bible also refer as our heart. Okay, when you say my heart, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. These are all actually in the soul, you know. Yeah, so the soul consists of our mind, conscious mind, subconscious mind, your belief system, okay, your attitude is part of your soul, your emotion, yeah, 喜怒哀乐, the Chinese say, your joy, your happiness, your sadness, your anger are in your emotion. And your memory is also in your soul. Yeah. And I wonder, when I pray for people, there are some people say, I lost some of my memory. Yeah. And some say, my mother got dementia. Okay, I warn you now, don't try to forget things, you know. I hate that person. I want to forget that person. And that person is like part of your life for 1 year. And some told me, say, Pastor, I forget my childhood. Standard 1 to 3, I cannot remember. And when I checked with them, actually, I found out that they have some unhappy thing happened during those times. Yeah. And we suppress the emotion. We suppress the memory. And so we choose and pick, yeah. And so some of the part we forgotten. And there are too many hurtful things you want to forget. And sometimes your memory, a lot of them actually are suppressed and lost. So the beautiful thing in CTP is that we help you to discover it and release it out and give it to Jesus. Don't suppress it. If you do not have closure for all these hurts and pain, you carry it even to your old age. Yeah. And so in emotion healing, we allow it to come forth, you know, and ask God, say, help me to deal with it. And Jesus take it away. We give it to him. And there is a healing come to that part of our memory, that soul. Okay. Yeah. And the soul is actually like returning back. Restoring back, you know, restore my soul. Yeah. And so your soul is your will as well, your willpower. Okay. Yeah. Your mind, your emotion. I have another diagram to illustrate that. Your soul is your mind, will, emotion. Okay. I'm going to post this in our CDP. So don't worry. Yeah. So, and your soul part is the part that will help you to relate to other people. Okay? So if your soul is healthy, you have a good relationship. Okay? If your soul is healthy, you have good relationship with people. Okay? And so if our soul is not healthy, our soul is hurting. It's just like, you know, anything that make you hurt, it is still stored in your CPU, in your heart, in your soul. So, you know, we are the one who create the computer. We make computer. Yeah, we create computer and we invented the computer. And same thing like computer. If anything you put inside that is bad, that is virus, that is poisonous, it will be still there. It will not be gone. Even you have forgotten about it, and as the time go by, it piles up and you don't clear it, your computer will hang. Same thing with your brain, your memory, same thing. Clear them off. Create in me, Lord, a clean heart. Renew a right spirit within me. David say that. David has some problem. He is a very godly man. I respect him. He pray every time he go for war. But how come I say he make this mistake, commit a murder and commit adultery? Yeah, he is capable to do that because his great-great-grandmother is Rahab. Okay, so in the last lesson, CTP 11, lesson 5, I'm talking about generation or iniquity, bloodline iniquity, which is a very important part. So now I'm talking about the soul part, our soul, which we are responsible. So if your soul is not healthy, you will always find problem. You cannot get along with people. Okay. Yeah. That's why there are all these problems of the young people today. When they go out to work, they cannot communicate. And then they go through a lot of misunderstanding, and then they don't dare to step up again. Okay. So these are the problem of society now, not only in Malaysia. Right, Malaysia is catching up, but Japan, there are so many of them. Yeah, okay, so they are called hikikomori. All right, and so the body, we know how to take care. The soul is a place where we are going to deal with it. For this few session, I will help you to clear. Okay, so don't give up, no matter how struggle you are now. I know sometimes when you go too depressed, and your children are having problems, yeah, it's a very stressful situation. I will encourage you. Yeah, I post some of the experience and testimony of the parents who go through when they pray and they themselves got the release and healing. Then they no longer ask me, Pastor, how can I pray for my daughter? They know what to do already. Amen. So I'm going to teach you, equip you to know how to do it for your family member. Okay, you are the best person to help them. Okay. Yeah. And the spirit is the part where we communicate and relate to God. Okay. So there will be certain degree for us, the Asian people, the Chinese, we involve very much. If you don't come from a Christian family, you most probably involve with idol worship. So I will also help you to clear this part, which is actually, I've been doing it for 30 years. Okay. But the soul part is the reason. 5 years, yeah, I am dealing with it. So good, and seeing a lot of improvement. Okay, so our soul can get unwell, like David say, yeah, this, okay, yeah. Lillian, can you please read for me Psalm 43, verse 5?
Why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you disquieted me within me? Hope in God, for I shall yet praise him, the help of my countenance and my God.
Amen. Thank you. Amen. Hallelujah. So you can see David even encourages his own soul. Yeah. So, you know, our soul can feel down. Yeah. At one place, yeah, the Lord ministered to me. He said, even you make your bed in hell, I am there. Oh, I was so comforted in a way that you feel like you are in hell. Yeah. You feel so bad. But God say, I know how you feel. Even you make your bed in sure, you know, in hell, I'm there. Even you are up with a high spirit, up there at the, in the sky, you know, in heaven, I am there with you. So no matter how bad you feel and how depressed you feel, God is with you. Yeah. So sometimes people who are depressed, they felt like people forsake me. No, I think God also will not like me, you know, I am so lousy. Okay, now I'm going to this very important part. You will learn things from here. Okay, when a person's soul, okay, I help you to know, to detect if a person's soul is not well, what are the symptoms? Okay, so when I share this, you will begin to observe that there are things like this happen in your life, or maybe in your families or some friends that you know of. Okay, first of all, you cannot focus on things. You cannot focus in doing things. You are always easily distracted. Okay, you might feel you're very healthy physically, but when you want to do something, you cannot feel the peace, you know, just to sit down and to do it and to finish it. Okay, one very important thing is you cannot focus in reading the Bible. And when you read the Bible, you fall asleep. Okay, yeah, anybody want to raise your hands? You know, yeah, thank God for Anita, very honest. I do have, I think, quite a number. Okay, when you find that when you read the Bible or you listen to your pastor, if your pastor is not a boring pastor, or you find the other are still awake, but you're falling asleep, okay? All right, something wrong with your soul. I will say that. Your soul is the partner, well, resisting to the word of God. And you feel like sleepy when, you know, the word is being preached and you read the Bible, you begin to fall asleep. I tell you, I do encounter many of these cases. In the cell group, I still run a cell group with the ladies. Okay, we sit circles, you know, and we sit pretty close because of the space of the room, okay, in the shop. We are having a fellowship. And there's one who came to the Lord. When I share, you know, the rest of them are awake, you know, she will start falling asleep. And she falls asleep, you know, even her head lay on the other person's shoulder, you know. And not only that, got snoring some more. The sound, snoring. I say, what a lady, you know. It's so embarrassed, right? Yeah, but thank God, she very thick skin. She takes skin away. She say, okay, I know I'm my problem. Pastor, help me. Yeah. I thank God I met her. Yeah. Again, she is okay already. Yeah. This is actually the soul problem. I have one sister who is in my CDP class. Yeah. And she raised her hand and said, yeah, for 10 years I've been Christian. I still haven't finished my Bible. And I fall asleep, you know. And you know not, she graduated from ST. I don't want to mention Bible school name. Yeah, she's graduated master, you know, a graduate from Bible school. All right, but she falls asleep when she read the Bible. Okay, so her soul actually got problem. Okay, she was bullied when she was in university, and she's an introvert. Later, I'm going to share this story. And she went through the prayer. And she went through the Bible speed reading, and she prays a lot. She had a breakthrough. Yeah, now she's doing research and things like that. Okay, so please don't be shy to acknowledge that, or else forever you will be sleepy when I speak. Okay, and then you feel, yeah, you miss this, you miss that, you know, and you have slept well and enough, but yet you still want to sleep when come to reading Bible. Something wrong. Okay. Yeah, so that is about the soul, but praise the Lord, God can set us free. Hallelujah. So I am sharing to you tomorrow class on Bible speed reading, okay? If you can, you just drop by. You know, all the courses are free of charge, okay? So, you know, I put my bank account there just to, for you, whoever want to give a love gift and so on, just give. Yeah, so I want to encourage people to read the Bible to get free in your soul. Okay, the next thing is that you cannot think positively. You always think like, I cannot do. Or even you think about other people, they tell you certain things, you say that I cannot do Lana, you know, fail one, sure, you know, I tried this before, you know. And so always think negative, not positive. Okay, if you had this sort of attitude, something is not right with your soul. Okay, you have gone through most probably a lot of disappointment with people, with yourself, and even with God. Okay. So, yeah, this one of indicator. Number two, you cannot sleep well, okay? Or you have nightmares, okay? Like you have insomnia, okay? So, I thank God, people who pray through CTP, one of the very frequent good result and positive feedback is that, Pastor, I can sleep now, okay? Have you really, you know, gone through Sleepless night, you cannot sleep. You're so scared. You have not been sleeping for one, two night. You know, your mind can get haywire. You know, yeah. And I thank God people who gone through this and who do BSSR Bible speed reading. The whole family, they told me, Pastor, my whole family read the Bibles before we sleep. And all of us sleep so soundly. Okay, so one of the good news is that, you know, God is going to heal you, yeah, through removing your negative emotion. Okay, yeah. As I share this, I will usually share testimony. So that I want you to know that this are not only theory, but this is practically you can experience it. Okay, so I have a sister. I am going to post her testimony. She wrote a very clear testimony when she go through the prayer with me. All right. And she was not able to sleep well. She is about maybe 50 years old. All right. But this happened since his childhood. I have never seen a person having insomnia, even at teenage, you know, she experienced that. So I say, I must help you to find out what is the causes, the root cause. So when I pray with her and she start to share her life, right? So in CTP, you need to open up your heart, your life, okay? And be willing to deal with everything that is negative that you experience, okay? Do not be afraid to let it come out and let it go, right? And she remember, she said, I remember my mom told me that she tried to abort me twice by taking certain medicine, but, you know, she failed to abort me, right? So she, as a child in her mother's womb, she experienced rejection. She experienced emotionally, my mother does not want me to be alive. Can you imagine if your mom want to kill you, you know? Right? Your emotion. So she was rejected, she was hurt. And she didn't know that. After she was given birth, her mom loved her, cared for her. But in the womb, she experienced fear, even life-threatening situation. Imagine when you're in your mother's womb, you have spirit, you have soul, you know, you can feel, right? But you might not know, you know, the memory things, but it's in your memory, right? You know what happened when I pray with her to ask her to give it to Jesus? Jesus can take it away from you. Wow, that night, the next day she called me, Pastor, I can sleep last night. Wow, it's so powerful, powerful than any medication. Yeah, it's from God. Amen. And that day I asked her, Sister, I need your testimony in the word file. I need someone to translate it to Chinese. And she told me, she said, Pastor, I still can sleep. So I'm so happy. I say it is lasting. Amen. Yeah. So just tell people who cannot sleep, come and do CTP. Right? And some people become even worse, hearing voices. Yeah, like I say, so people who are having schizophrenia, yeah, they might be coming to a stage of hearing voices. Yeah, so I deal with people who have this hearing voices. The voice asks her, you know, as a Christian, yeah, don't sleep in the bed tonight. Sleep in the bathtub, okay? Or sleep next day, sleep at the staircase. How to sleep in bathtub and staircase, right? And the voice say, I'm training you to be a soldier for Jesus Christ. Well, these are the religious spirit, all right? And praise the Lord, after, you know, she go through the emotion healings and spiritual deliverance, she's well. She's a Sunday school teacher all the while, right? But how come it can happen to Christian, okay? Remember one very verse that you, when you become a Christian, you always memorize. If I am in Christ, we are what? New creation, right? Behold, the old has passed. Behold, all things has become new. So we say, why bother, Pastor, to deal with the old things? But I tell you, actually, this verse is a presence continuous then. You are becoming new every day. It's not overnight. Okay, yeah. So I believe many of us acknowledge my old character, my old temper, they are still there. You know, they don't change overnight. My old self. Yeah, but I'm guaranteed I have the Spirit of God in me and the Word of God. Yeah, if I persistent allowing myself, God will mold me and change me, and I am renewing and become new every day. It's not overnight. So the old thing has not passed away. We are dealing with the old thing now, and we want to let it go and let pass it to Jesus. Yeah, and therefore you find that you are new creation when you deal with all this. All right, so we don't want to, you know, lie to ourselves. Yeah, our old character, our old temper, our anger, you know, our old behavior, bad habits, they are still there. All right, and it takes time for us. Yeah, it's a cleansing process. It's the sanctification is a process. It takes time. Amen. So what we are doing today in CDP is a process of sanctification and healing and also setting apart. So voices, okay, can be dealt with, right? Or always suspicious of other. That is called paranoid. Okay, and this is happening to some people which I come across with. Okay, they're suspicious of their neighbor spying on them. Okay, and some of these people, they are very okay. They can talk, they can communicate, right? They can even go to work, but in their life, there are a lot of suspicion. They suspect the neighbor, you know, spying on them. Yeah, I know of someone, an artist, huh? Her picture and painting can sell a lot of money, you know. But she has this problem. She wake up at night, she will say, "Pastor, I actually suspect my neighbor is spying on me." Yeah, when I wake up, their light is on. You know, their car porch light is on, you know. And I have one to come, they come from prayer. She said, "Pastor, when I come up for prayers, you know, I set my curtain, okay, at a certain angle. When I go home, you know, last week, I find that the curtain has shifted." She said, "My neighbor actually spying on me." And then in my heart, I think, "Oh, who are you so important? Why your neighbor spying on you?" and she said, "My neighbor, actually, they are dealing with drugs, and I know their secret. That's why they are spying on me." I say, okay. I don't want to tell her, you know, I know she has problem. Okay, I have another students. My wife is a piano teacher. She has students, and the father had problems, you know, because of stresses and so on, a man. Say one day they woke up, you know, and the father actually suspect their Wi-Fi has been hacked. All their phone has been hacked. So they woke up, you know, all their phone lost, you know. When they asked the father, it was the father actually overnight at night, hide their phone somewhere, don't know where is it, you know. Yeah. So, you know, and he don't acknowledge that he has problem. Yeah. And so the wife actually putting medication onto his food, okay, to help him. So that he can come to his senses to deal with his problem. Yeah, sometimes it's like that. Yeah. So I agree. I don't reject medication. Okay. So if someone who really need to quiet down, who are so cannot sleep for so many nights and are not stable emotionally to talk and to deal with things and to go through counsel and prayer. So it's good to take medication, all right, prescribed by the doctor, so that the person can calm down and they can deal with and can talk to, can reason. And from there, the doctor will know when they are well. They will help them to wean off the dosage. Okay. Yeah, so I help people who are taking medication, who actually get well, and now no more depend on medication. The doctor usually will say you have to eat for life. Okay, I was helping a datuk. He's very well to do. You know, he has 50 outlets of his shop and so on. But he was in depression. He is like a robot. He cannot go for meeting, he cannot make decision. So he need other people to help him. Okay. And so when he deal with his life, all the wrong lifestyles and so on, you know, now thank God he is a good father. Now he hug his children. He celebrate the children's birthday. No more girlfriend outside. Yeah. And now, a family man. And he's well. And he's no need to take medication. The doctor told him, he said, you have to take for life. Okay. Yeah. So the doctor will know. So, and anger, people who are always angry or always feel sad or feel sad and worry, but do not know why. Okay. It is a accumulation of the anger, sadness, yeah, and injustice, indifferences in your heart that you didn't have a closure. Okay, all this will pop until a time you cannot take it anymore. Okay, yeah, you have a limitation of all this. Yeah, and so therefore, you know, the psalmist always talking to God. They're releasing this negative emotion to God. So this what we are doing in CDP is to release your negative emotion. Can we say together, negative emotion? Okay, yeah, you're going to hear these words very often. All right, and you give it to the Lord. Sadness, anxious, body aching. Yeah, so many people, I find that, yeah, those who are very stressful, they're always having this, what, the back pain, yeah, over the shoulder, the tightness, yeah, yeah. And so that is one of the signs, yeah, of this stress. I have actually seen this happen to my own member, yeah, who are going through marital strain, you know, and very heartache, you know, yeah. But when you go to church, yeah, of course the pastor will tell you, you can do all things to Christ who strengthen you, and then you will declare you will do it, but then after some time you feel tired, isn't it? Because the negative emotion is not dealt with. Okay, so through Christ, you can do it. Remove the negative emotion. Or else it's come into a form of stress over your shoulder. I have one brother, he is a worship leader of a church, and he is also helping in a prayer altar, praying for the country. She's in charge of that. But he has one problem. He said, Pastor, I want to get rid of this. You know, my relationship with my father is no good. Whenever, you know, he sit down, you know, when I'm talking to my mom, then we'll stop talking. We got nothing to say when he sit down. He don't like his father because he found out, you know, his father is a military man, very hard on him when he is a child, when raising him up, very strict, very disciplined. He don't feel the love from the father. And moreover, one day, he said, I was playing with my sister, one day running here and there, bump into the father's pawn, you know, the video. And he lost all his respect to the father as a Christian. Yeah. And then he find it very difficult to talk to father. But when she came to the CDP class, I have his testimony. I will post it. She said, she deal with it. And he used to have a back problem here. He have to see a chiropractor, regularly to deal with his back problem. But after the second prayer, after the lesson, and he said, hey, Pastor, you know, today I don't feel the pain, you know. He said, after this third time I'm seeing you, and I told my wife, he said, my wife is very skeptical. He said, let's see whether after 1 month it's still, you know, no more pain, you know. And true enough, praise the Lord, he is free from his back pain. Yeah. So the emotion healing and spiritual deliverance will lead to physical healing. Okay. Some of your physical pain and weaknesses could be due to your emotional problem. And I say, through my observing as a pastor for 30 years, I do have member like that. They told me, Pastor, today I'm having fever. I think, no, I cannot host the cell group. I say, are you sure you're having fever? Do you really use the thermometer to see? He said, no, I feel the heat, you know. And so actually it's actually the feeling and emotion. Feel sick, yeah, but that's actually it's not sick. Okay, so these are emotional things. So the pain, the diarrhea, the discomfort of the stomach, especially for children, if they are stressed, they tell you, say, I don't want to go to school, I got stomach pain. Yeah, and they even really diarrhea one, you know. Yeah, they don't tell lies, they really feel like that. Okay, my nephew was like that. Every time my mother want to bring him to school, he said, Popo, my 我的肚子痛, 我不可以去读书. Yeah, and always stress, actually. Okay, so children also. Okay, and moving down, chest pain, difficult in breathing, shallow in breathing. Okay, so when I had this depression for 3 months, I was having this problem. Yeah, I thought I'm going to have a heart problem or so on, you know. And I don't want to go and see a doctor. I am cyclist, you know. I go cycling, I go swimming. I say if I can cycle one more round, I don't die, and means I got no heart problems. So I force myself cycling a few rounds. Oh, I say thank God. I say got no heart problem. But sometimes I have this heart race. Okay, the heart beat very fast. This is called what? Panic attack. Yeah, I don't know. Actually, it's a psychological things, you know. My heart beat so fast. One day I was in Fraser's Hill taking a break, you know. Wow, midnight, my heart raced so fast. I thought I'm going to have a heart attack. I told the caretaker, please send me down to the hospital. I'm going to have a heart attack. But they say to me, Pastor, cannot. You know, now, you know, it's like one way, you know, it's very dangerous. Cannot go down. So I rested. The next day, I was okay. Yeah. So I read a book, you know, I was watching a video when I'm doing counseling. You know, I saw this panic attack. Your heart will beat very fast, like you're going to have a heart attack. Then later I know this is called panic attack. Okay. And then there's another one called anxiety attack. Okay. So it's all because of your emotional. You are very tense. A lot of stress in you and it piles up. Okay, your adrenaline rush has been keep going on and going on. You are at a verge of like everything very kanjiang. You know, I went to see a doctor, a GP. She told me, say, Pastor, are you very stressed? I say, no, I'm only 30 over years old. Why they got stress? And then I say, can you tell me why is stress? She say like this. You will drive to this place, and then after that, you will drive to another place, and then you're going to do and attend to another thing. Oh, I said, yeah, that's how I work. Oh, see, that is stress. Wow. So, you know, so I do not know. Ignorant. Okay, ignorant. So, yeah, so we are learning. So, thank God, this is going to be a society problem. All right. If you don't know, you're going to cause stress to your children. And then your children will have problem. And then they will give you problem. All right. And it's a long term, you know, I tell you. It's very dangerous sometimes. And it robbed them off of their life. No more life. You also got no more life, I tell you. All right. So, but thank God it can be helped. Okay. So fear, unreasonable fear, unknown fear, phobia. Okay. So lately I'm helping one brother, he has phobia. He is a sportsman. Yeah, I saw his, you know, WhatsApp, his photo is a cyclist, you know. And he's a businessman. I mean, he's sent to different country, fly over different places. But that day, only I think last month, he developed a fear of flying. He cannot imagine himself in an enclosed place. He has a problem when he go to the washroom to take bath. He cannot take it, you know, the space, the narrow space. So she has claustrophobia. Okay. And thank God through prayer, we find out what happened. Okay. They are all emotional. That day he called me, he said, Pastor, I'm now back. I flew back from Singapore to Malaysia and I have overcome it. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So if you do not know how to deal, you will have to take medication. Then still cannot. It might go even more intense. You will take a higher dose of medication. Okay. So medication is only temporarily. It doesn't help you to remove the root cause. Okay. In Christian counseling, CTP, it helps you to remove the root cause. And Jesus go into your past and heal you. Amen. Hallelujah. Addiction, same thing. Okay, shopaholic or alcoholic, everything. Most of them are emotional. Drugs also. Okay, I have a friend. He went over to Japan. He was very well. But when he came back, he was so stressed because of the life and also the system in Malaysia so different from Japan. Everything to him is unpredictable. Traffic, timetable, everything. And he became so stressed, he went back to drugs. He was a drug addict. Okay, so culture, yeah, addiction, everything is hidden. Even after 10 years, it will still come back and look for you. Okay, I'm not trying to scare you. Okay, self-injury. Yeah, I'm seeing young people now, mainly young people cutting themselves. I only just had 2 days, someone told me, say my children is cutting themselves. I saw, I heard that, I seen that in dealing with LGBT, yeah, gay and lesbian. Do you know why? Some of us, we don't know. Why do they cut themselves? Because they are very painful in their heart. Their heart, the Chinese saying, oh, ho sam tong. There is such thing as heart pain, you know. When you are divorced, when you are separated, when someone whom you love pass away, you feel very heartache. It's really true, you know. The heart can feel the pain. And so sometimes people cannot wake up every day, think about the same thing and feel the pain. They start cutting themselves physically and make themselves physically pain so that they can forget about the pain in their heart temporarily. Yeah. So therefore, I've seen people wearing long sleeve and then there's a lot of cut in their hands, young people, yeah, in the colleges. Yeah. And this can be healed. Yeah, I went to hospital to visit the children ward, cancer ward. Some of them were having brain tumor and they are feeling so pain. I saw them. I don't know why, but I later realized they are knocking at the wall to cause a physical, you know, the outer pain and then distract the inner pain inside the brain, the tumor. Okay, so God wants to take away our pain. Amen. Hallelujah. And number nine, I am going to also talk about LGBT. One topic later. Why is it like that? LGBT is not born with this problem. Okay? No. I believe, because I have worked with some of them and I know their causes of what? Either being sexually abused or most of them, high percentage, 80 to 90% is lack of father and mother's love. I can really prove to you many cases. Okay, I'm going to talk about that in the the third lesson. Okay, so another one is suicidal thought. If you have suicidal thought, you have never did it, but you have this thought, flashing thoughts to you, you have to keep record it, and we're going to pray through this, right? Anorexia. Okay, I at least have two cases. Yeah, one is my sister, the other one is my church sister many years ago. She couldn't eat and she's so thin, she's about to die. Her sister took her to the church, right? Her sister is a Christian, and we pray for her, and we do not know how to deal with it. Actually, we do not know how to deal with emotion that time. We only do spiritual deliverance. So we depend very much on our gifting, spiritual gift. We operate in a team with spiritual gift. And one of them, they received when they pray for this sister. He said, I saw a vision. As you walk home with your school bag, you enter into the house and there is an altar, the Chinese altar. So left with, I think, one orange there. Okay, and you want to take the orange, and your mom stopped you and say, this is for your sister. Okay, and you hated your mother in your heart. And you say in your heart, I will never eat your food again. And that's how she began to develop vomiting and digestion problem, and she cannot take food, you know. And she ended up so skinny, and yeah, it's actually going to die. And the sister actually the one, yeah, took her to church and we prayed, and the Lord spoke to her. He said, yes, it happened to me. And she confessed her sin. She asked for forgiveness. She released her mother, yeah, and reconciled with her mother. Praise the Lord. She can start eating. Yeah, it's emotional. It's not, people say she got a curse or what. You know, always we say, oh, God, people release curse on them. No, I tell you, sometimes it is not. But sometimes it is because you have so much of these emotional troubles and forgiveness in your life, you totally have an open door. The curses flying by will easily drop. Okay, as the proverb say. Yeah, I'm going to show you the verse later. So a curse without a cause will not alight. the Bible say, right? So do not be afraid of curses, okay? But if your life have a lot of these problems, you have to check. You are most probably having a lot of negative emotion that need to get rid. Once it is get rid of, you have the joy of the Lord. Okay, you begin to become healthy physically and emotionally. Okay, all right. Another thing is low self-esteem. Okay, insecurity and violent. All right. So there are some people are so violent, insecure, always very suspicious, always very sensitive, you know. Yeah. So low self-esteem. Hate yourself, right? Don't like yourself. I'm not good enough. I am hopeless. I'm helpless. Okay, so I'm going to share to you more in detail in this later. After this 5 minutes break, I'm going into this area, okay, to help you. Why do you have all this symptom? It is all because of this area. Okay, you go through brokenness in your soul. Your soul go through hurts and pain. These are the area. Hallelujah. I'm going to continue to share to you this very important part. Okay, if you go through trauma in your life, yeah, things are really like a crisis suddenly happened to you before, even though it's 10 years ago. Don't tell yourself, we Chinese have a word that say, you know, times will make everything pass away. Yeah, let time help me to clear off all this. Yeah, no, it will not. It will stay in your CPU if you don't deal with it, if you don't give it to Jesus. Okay, so separation, yeah, leaving someone you love, or maybe, you know, divorce, something very hurting, yeah, always it will hurt any one of us. So divorce is like two pieces of paper stick together, and you ask me to tear it off without making any tearing, or yeah, it's impossible. They will always hurt. And this hurt also will bring it to your children, yeah. Okay, it will definitely affect. All right. So if you've gone through this, yeah, and you have separation before, someone whom you love, even your grandmother, whoever that took care of you, yeah, you are separated or you are being rejected, yeah, in a relationship. You feel very hurt. You have been abandoned. Okay. And you also go through abortion. Your mom want to abort you. Yeah. An accident, robbery, yeah, all this, yeah, and culture, differences you go through, yeah, or war, yeah, to some of us might not be, right, and abuse, okay, physical abuse, yeah, sexually abused, yeah. So I have one brother, I help him, he's a gay, all right, he's already about 60 over years old. And he got married because he has this problem. And he thought by getting married and children can get rid of this problem. But still, no. She feels so shameful. He is so afraid that his daughter, family member will find out he is still going to a gay bar. Okay, I was checking with him. I said, what actually happened in your childhood? Then I realized she was sexually abused by the father who opened the coffee shop, the chef actually sexually abused him. And afterwards, he tend to be attracted to men, right? He's still looking for men, yeah. And so sexually abuse actually hurts the person's soul and causes, listen to this term, soul tie, ungodly soul tie. If you have sex with anyone, you will have a soul tie. It will forever, unless you cut it off in the name of Jesus. So when we commit adultery or fornication, it's actually against the word of God, right? And it will cause a soul tie that happened, that you cannot love God and love the one that you are married to with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, with all your might. There will be problems in relationship. Therefore, this is what God meant. Sex is only for our only person, our husband or wife. Yeah. And so any form of sex outside of a marriage is considered as like idolatry. Yeah. Yeah. So, okay. So, separation, adultery that happened, sexually abused. Yeah, if anyone gone through, you have to cut off. I will teach you. This is on the third lesson. Okay. Yeah. All right. And sicknesses. Yeah. After sicknesses, stroke, abortion, miscarriage, it can cause a depression. Yeah. Emotional problem. Okay. If you come from a family culture, parents always quarrel, fighting and beating, alcoholism, and father abusing the children, words abuse. I've heard actually some of those in the class. You say, I woke up, my mother scold me. He dragged me out from the bed by my hair and scold me. I don't know how to respond. Some children, they are not so quick in response, and parents are very upset when their children don't respond. Talk to me. What do you want? You know, and keep scolding. He said, this is what I got every day. Wow, I said, I cannot imagine it so bad. Yeah. So thank God, she don't have depression, but she has a very passive attitude. That's why he cannot work in the company. He said, I don't know how to talk to my colleague. When I do not know how to do the work, I don't dare to ask. I ended up being misunderstood by my colleague. And that's why he cannot work anymore. So I have many young people like that. They cannot communicate. Yeah, for guy playing game and very good result playing game, but don't know how to relate to people. Okay, yeah. So unhappy childhood, unhealthy family culture. Actually, I can really say, as I minister to children and family, sometimes your family, I'm not trying to say bad things, okay? Your family culture might not be healthy. You do not know until you grow up. Until you meet with your friends, you go to your friend's house, you find that, oh, father and mother can be so lovely, can talk like that, no? Not only to shout one, okay? And then you find your family shouting one, and scolding, don't have peace. You thought it's like that. So one child, that day, I can't remember who told me, he said, he just realized, she thought every family, every children grow up eating Maggie Mee, you know. This is what she did. And until she grew up, she found out that no, it's not. So really, we need healing. Our family needs healing. Okay. Unhappy childhood, if you've gone through, it's okay. No, we don't have a perfect family. Yeah, but the good thing is that I'm seeing people still can be healed. All right. Yeah. Family can be single mother, you know, sometimes because we are in a imperfect world or in a broken world. So sometimes we grow up as a single child. Yeah. But I tell you, okay, if you don't have mother's love, you don't have father's love. Okay. Our God, He created us in His image, male and female. So in God, there is a mother's love and also a father's love. You see, have you seen a mother, a nursing mother, forget about his baby? God say, I will not forget you. That is a mother's love. Yeah. And we call our God Heavenly Father. All right. So we can find our love, a father's that we don't have. And of course, I will say the church are supposed to have all this also. Yeah. That someone, you are good, you have the love, you can love the children who don't have a good family, yeah, like a mother's love, walk with them, yeah, and build them up. And God say, yeah, you do not have many fathers, you have thousands of instructors, but you do not have many fathers. So we need fathers, we need mothers, amen, yeah. So all these are part of the symptom and also the reason, okay, why we are going through of all this, okay.